Moti, source of influencers.
Who's your best magician ever?
That's an interesting question. There's so many good magicians, you know? I think, in my opinion, one of the best magicians in the world is a guy named Mr. Electric. And he's my mentor in magic. His real name's Marvin Roy, and you can look online and find his act. He was very famous from the 1940s to the 1990s, and he lit light bulbs in his hand. He'd take a light bulb, a big 1,000-watt light bulb, hold it in his hand, and it would light up. Super bright. You couldn't even look at it. If you're watching the show, you'd have to look away. And he made a living for 50 years touring the world. He played the Lido in Paris. He played Radio City Music Hall in New York, all over the world. He toured Liberace, the famous piano player back in the day. He's still alive. He's 94 in Palm Springs, and he's my mentor. So to me, that is one of my favorite acts in the world. The other act is an act that probably nobody knows, but if you Google it, you'll find that his name is Cardini. And he was very famous in the 30s to the 60s. And he always dressed in a full tuxedo. But he always acted like he was a little bit drunk. So he's always classy. And he had an eye monocle. You know the guys that have the monocle and the chain hangs down?
Yeah.
And he had that. And his assistant was a bellhop, which was his Swan was her name. And that was, I believe, his wife that worked as his assistant. But he always acted like he was walking into the entrance of a big hotel, like a very fancy hotel. And she was the bellhop, the one that carries the suitcases, a little hat, the suit. And that was always her character. And he'd be in the lobby. This would be the act on stage. He'd be in the lobby, and he'd be kind of bumbling around. All of a sudden, he'd look in the air, and he'd produce a cigarette out of the air. And he'd put the cigarette in his mouth, and he'd go to get a match. And you pull out a box of matches, and you see the box, you go to strike the match, and then the matches would be gone. And all of a sudden the cigarette would be lit. He'd be smoking, but he'd shock himself. Everything he did, he would be surprised at, as well as the audience. So it was very interesting, because you knew, he knew what he was doing, but he acted like he didn't know what was going on. And that's not easy to do, you know, because you gotta do stuff, and then act like you didn't do stuff, you know? And then all of a sudden the cigarette would be lit, and then he would take the cigarette like this and throw it down the ground, and the cigarette would be back in his mouth again. And he'd be shocked again. He'd take it and throw it down and back in his mouth again. And then he'd take the cigarette and throw it down, and then all of a sudden cards would come out of his mouth. He had cards in his mouth. And then all of a sudden he'd throw the cards down, and he'd be looking this way, and all of a sudden a fan of cards would appear here, and he'd bump right into them. So it was this act of him being shocked by himself. Very famous act. So, to me, he's actually one of my favorite acts in the business. He's not around anymore, of course. He's passed away, but he was a legend in the business. So there you go.
Do you know how to do those tricks?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, you can do the same?
Yeah, I do. And I can do, but that was his act and his style, you know. I liked the comedy of it. I liked how he acted, you know, the way it was. You know, I liked the fact that he acted dumbfounded or shocked at his own magic that he didn't even know he was doing, you know. I think that was very cool, you know, because I don't think people realize how hard it is. Like, if you know you're going to produce cards here, you have to know because you're doing it. But you're acting like you're looking over this way, and then you run into the cards, you know? But you already know they're there. So you have to act like you don't know that they're there, but they are there, and you know, if that makes sense.
But are those tricks still available for people to see?
Those videos are, sure, online. You can go online. If you type in Cardini, he has a couple of videos of him online, yeah. It's great. It's really cool to watch. Because, you know, I don't care whether we're doing YouTube, like you and I are, or we're being comedians, or magicians, or jugglers, or actors. I don't care what it is. There's always someone that we're following. You know what I mean? There's always somebody that started it before us that we're learning from. You know what I mean? I refuse to believe that I'm that original, you're that original, that we've invented something. I believe we've invented something or we're doing something because someone else invented something to help us invent something. You know what I mean? The world's been around for too long for us not to, you know? So as magicians, we copy and we change things and we mold things. It's like YouTube videos, these funny videos that I do, the pranks that I do with the police officers and all that. Well, that's like Charlie Chaplin, you know? Charlie Chaplin did stuff with the cops, you know, Charlie Chaplin with the hat and the mustache and the cane. He never talked, but he always did stuff online with cops or with old ladies or crossing the street. If you watch any of his old video, well, that's really what we're doing. But in this day and age, we're using YouTube. We're using more modern things. But back in the day, that was modern for Charlie Chaplin, you know? So we're always copying or, you know, trying to emulate someone else that we've seen from the past, even if we don't even know why we're doing it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Follow the Moti on Instagram, Facebook, and Snapchat.